Got a car. Huh? Does anybody know what the kind of car it is? So it's a 1966 Mercury Comet Capri. Doors work nice. It needs some interior work. Headliner's halfway presentable. It's got some spots like over there and stuff. Manual windows, like they should be. And for the powerhouse here, she's a 200 cubic inch six-cylinder. For myself, I would just leave that in there. It says it runs, but it has a little bit of, what'd you say it does?
Yeah, you know, once it warms up, it'll idle, but it just doesn't want to take the gas right. And I think it's probably something to do with the ignition and possibly carburetor. I'm pretty sure the carburetor too. Probably both.
Yeah, it could be. The better the bushing in the shaft likes to wear out on the old points ones, and then they'd walk around and make the dwell go all over the place.
I haven't even pulled the cap off. The distributor cap. I haven't done anything but drive it here.
Said it had a little wobble in the front end, but we figured that out, we think.
A little bit of cords, maybe.
I mean, it's got some surface rusting off, but it's kind of all there. There are no big major holes or nothing. I haven't really looked underneath of it yet. He said it doesn't look that bad under there.
There's no body work on it. Quit driving it in 86 or 87.
87 is when the inspection sticker was.
It's sitting there abroad since.
Probably what saved you, you know. You can see the. It must have that power steering assist on it. The ram. Let's get this here, the worst part I see. We'll have to poke around that and make sure that's okay. Other than that, under there, I mean, you guys probably can't see nothing. It doesn't look all that bad. Anybody know anything about these to know where the weaknesses are other than here? Oh, let me get up. So I think what he's gonna do is we're gonna do some work on it. Get it, be a runner and a driver. And then he's gonna decide if he's gonna keep it or get rid of it. He traded the truck for it, so. It did drive here. Here's what we got in here. And here's some stuff in there. There's one little hole there, I see. There's the fuel tank. I mean, there's some, but for a 66, it's not that terrible. Definitely fixable. You could actually make some really nice car if they wanted to put the all the work into it. Does it start? No, without a battery, huh? See, the gas tank's right there, but I don't know what the story is on the gas tank. This is the first I've seen any of it. Right there is the gas tank for right now. So anyway, this is what he's starting with. Like I say, we just want to be able to get it to where it can be driven and street legal and then decide what's going on from there. So we're gonna see if it'll fire up. What you came with. The headlight rings are there. The bucket. I'm missing a bucket. Wonder if it's in the back trunk or something.
I'm gonna go out and pick the guy's brain again and see if he can find any more parts laying around, if there's anything there.
Yeah, one part would be worth it.
Yeah.
Alright, so we may have some more videos on this. Because I may help you do some of the stuff to get it rolling. If anybody's interested. So is he going to make it in here without crashing? Defroster in the back window, and it looks like one of them that they used to sell you taped in, the aftermarket ones. Maybe, maybe not, I don't know. I would say they didn't have that in 66, but what do I know? Anybody got any information they'd like to share on these cars, or where to get parked or something? You can leave that in the description. It'd be appreciated.